Tell you what rhymes with orange, and that's awesome. It's the orange team.
Commercial fishing is one of the most dangerous occupations in the world. Fishermen can be at sea for 90 days facing 0 degrees Celsius water, often 50 miles offshore. Hi, I'm Zeke. And these are my teammates, Wendy and Emily. Behind me in the tanks are Scott and Brandon, but we'll get to them in a minute. Every commercial fishing vessel is required to have survival suits for their whole crew. Survival suits are waterproof dry suits designed to keep fishermen afloat and provide them life in 0 degrees Celsius water for 6 hours. In the event of an emergency, the crew alerts the captain, gets their survival suits and activates their flotation devices, and gets in the water, knowing that these survival suits will save them for 6 hours. And they wait. And they lay on their backs and stare at the sky because that's all there is. Their minds start to wander. Will they find me? I can't feel my hands. Will I see my kids again? Every single emergency procedure could have been executed flawlessly, and these survival suits keep them alive for 6 hours. They did everything they could have, and they get 6 hours. After learning about this problem and interviewing fishermen, we decided to create Vesta. Vesta will double this survival time, drastically increasing their chances of getting rescued by the Coast Guard. The first 12 hours are critical for Coast Guard rescues because after that time, the sea is just too big and fishermen are very hard to find. Now, this problem happens over several hours, but tonight we only have 7 minutes. So that's why Brandon and Scott are behind me in these tanks. As Scott drew the short straw, and so Brandon gets to wear Vesta for this demo. As you can see, Brandon's temperature is much higher than Scott's. They got in right before we started this demo, or right before we started this presentation, and that's where they're at now. So, thank you. Can we get a round of applause for Scott and Brandon? But this immediate effect wasn't enough for us. We needed to know that Vesta will help fishermen for 6 hours. So we got Brandon to put on a survival suit and go in a pool, in a parking lot, outside. And we planned a 6-hour test as a baseline. This is how that test went. You can see his temperature dropped quickly, and at an hour and a half, we had to pull him. We couldn't risk giving Brandon hypothermia. His hands were shaking, and there was even ice forming on his gloves. So we pulled him. And the next day, we had him put Vesta on under his survival suit. And this is that full 6-hour test. As you can see, Vesta drove his temperature to 34 degrees Celsius and kept it there the entire time. There was no statistically significant difference in temperature that entire period. Thank you. Vesta will be able to keep fishermen alive longer. And Wendy is going to tell us how.
We designed Vesta to be safe, easy to use, and most importantly, extend survival time to 12 hours. From our study, we found that in order to keep fishermen alive in freezing water, you need 200 watts of power. This is the same amount of power from an electric blanket. But over the course of 6 hours, you need 4.3 megajoules of energy, equivalent to charging your phone 150 times. We explored multiple approaches to supply this amount of energy and found that electrical heating using batteries is the most lightweight, controllable, and reliable method to keep your body warm. Vesta is powered by 33 lithium manganese dioxide battery cells located on the back of the vest. The battery weighs about 8 pounds, and we have tested that the additional weight can still allow you to stay afloat in the survival suits. The battery sends the power to 4 heating pads made out of waterproof, flexible silicone. We place the heating pads over the heart and the major organ to maintain core temperature and to spread heat throughout the whole body. The heating pad's temperature is automatically regulated to be kept within 45 to 55 Celsius to keep fishermen alive. To achieve this, we have a thermal sensor that measures the heating pad's temperature and sends the data to a microcontroller. It then adjusts the power output from the battery to the heating pads. You might think that having electronics and batteries in water creates a huge concern for safety. However, in addition to the waterproof feature of survival suit, we ensure that every single electronic component in Vesta is tested to be waterproof, and everything is enclosed in a water-resistant vest. For Vesta, we're using a special nylon as the outermost skin. Next, we have an insulation layer that helps retain heat and prevents fishermen from overheating. Survival suits are designed to be one size fits all, and so is Vesta. Fishermen will simply put Vesta over their heads and fit Velcro straps around their body. To activate, you simply press the power button. We're eager to start saving lives, and Emily will tell us how we plan to bring Vesta into the hands of fishermen.
There are over 83,000 commercial fishermen in the coldest regions of the U.S. We've spoken to fishermen in Alaska and Massachusetts, and they're excited to have Vesta on board. We've determined that the quickest way to bring Vesta to these fishermen is by licensing our technology. In order to begin this process, we have already filed a provisional patent application. Since Vesta was designed to be worn under a survival suit, we have begun reaching out to large survival suit manufacturers to potentially partner with. Vesta will be manufactured at a cost of $200. Since the majority of this cost is due to batteries, we believe it can decrease over time with advancements in battery technology. This would translate to a retail price of $600 for fishermen. However, since we will integrate Vesta into existing $600 suits, this would drive the total cost to $1,200. For double the retail price, fishermen will be able to double their survival time at sea. We're excited that we are able to keep our teammate Brandon warm on stage tonight. And Scott is even more excited to get out of this freezing water very soon. But our team as a whole is most excited to reach our ultimate goal, to extend fishermen's survival time at sea and allow them to return home safely. Thank you.
We're going to leave Brandon's temperature still running for the rest of Q&A, so we can keep watching.
Yeah. And he'll take questions, too.
Yeah.
While we're getting settled, I'm going to start with a question from Twitter. Mm-hmm. How does Vesta help with temperature in the extremities?
Sure, yeah, that's a great question and a big concern. So for survival time, the core temperature is important. That's why your body shuts off temperature to your hands and feet first when getting hypothermia. But when Brandon was doing the 6-hour test, his hands felt warm because we're heating the heart. The best way to get heat through your body is actually through your blood. And so by heating the heart, we're heating the rest of the body as well.
Thank you. Question up there.
Hi. Yes. So if you're trying to go down the route of extending the chances of someone getting fined and rescued out at sea, what was your motivation for going this route of, you know, adding these electronics and weight to extend the heating time versus, let's say, adding a GPS signal or some sort of locator like that, which would make it much easier for them to be found at sea?
Sure. So I'll talk to that again. That's a great suggestion. Those do exist, which is a big reason of why we wanted to improve the survival suit itself, is that those GPS trackers are a thing that people can buy. Yeah.
Thank you. Question up here? Up there.
Yeah. So I had a question about, have you had a chance to ask fishermen how the additional 8 pounds that they'll be wearing during their physically demanding job will affect their ability to do that long term over the course of a long, like 90-day fisherman extravaganza?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a great question. So the Vesta is used in emergency situations. So when a boat's about to go down, you put it on. And we talked to fishermen and asked them, so is weight a concern for you? And the answer is actually no, because they prioritize survival time over the weight and comfort.
Great, thank you. Good user research. We have a question from Jane Kokernak for Orange Team. Nice technical explanation of your design. Could you tell us what power sources you tested before you chose a battery? And what were the limitations of the other sources that you tested?
Yeah, so we actually spent the majority of our semester trying to figure out what power source we were going to use. And we looked heavily at chemicals because of their energy potential. However, although they did cut down on weight, per se, the control system required to control the reaction rates was much tougher and would actually probably put it up above the weight of the batteries themselves.
And also the primary cells that we're using right now is actually has a higher specific energy than calcium chloride, which we were testing, and both sodium acetate. So the weight is actually even lower for the lithium batteries.
Great, thank you. Question there.
Hi, so concerned citizen and local fan of chaos. So what sort of protocol or what sort of mechanism in place in case a large gash or a rip occurred in the nylon surrounding the electronics?
Yeah, thank you for the question. So regarding the batteries themselves, there's actually multiple layers protecting them. First, the batteries themselves have waterproof connections connecting each individual battery. Then the battery packs are rubberized and then inserted to a silicone sleeve or silicone casing. And then after that, the nylon cloth is on top of that. So if the nylon was to tear, you have these other ways to protect the battery packs themselves. Thank you.
Thank you. Last question over here.
Hi. Yeah. Sometimes in emergency situations on boats go down into the water quickly and sink quickly. And I know fishermen have emergency drills where they test how fast they can get into emergency suits. How does the putting on Vesta add to that time?
That's a great question. So actually, we did some tests for this. The gold standard right now is to get the survival suit on under a minute. And I actually was testing with the vest on the ground or stored and the suit stored, and I was able to get it on within 55 seconds. So we're hoping with practice, most people should be able to do this.
Thank you. Thank you, Orange Team.